In this chapter, we're trying to find the velocity or acceleration of an object with respect to another object. So for example, there are two cars going along a road, and you want to find the velocity of car A with respect to car B, that sort of thing. You will end up using two new equations. This one is for relative velocity, and this one is for relative acceleration. Depending on the question, each of these equations can be written in two ways. So let's quickly go over that. If a question says you want to find the velocity of object A with respect to B, then the equation will be written like this. So VA comes first, then VB, and then it's A over B. Now if the question says they want to find the velocity of object B with respect to A, we write it like this. In this case, B comes first, then A, and then it's B over A. It's important to make sure you get this right and write it properly depending on what the question is asking for, or you will end up with the wrong answers. The same goes for acceleration. The other thing you need to keep in mind is breaking down velocity and acceleration into vector components. In a nutshell, what we will do is break the velocity of object A into components and then the velocity of object B into components. And we will end up plugging those values into the equations I mentioned before. The same goes for acceleration. So let's go over four examples step by step and see how we can apply these new equations. By the end, you should be able to solve most, if not all, the problems you face in this chapter. In this question, we need to determine the velocity of plane B with respect to plane A. The first step is to establish which sides we will say is going to be positive. We will assume up and to the right to be positive. Next, we need to break down the velocity of each of the airplanes into vector components. So looking at plane A, we see that it's traveling straight down in the vertical direction. That means it will only have the J component, because the I component is zero. So it's negative 500 J. It's negative because it's going down and we chose up to be positive. Now we will focus on plane B. This plane is going at an angle, which means it will have both components. I've drawn the vector components, so we just need to write them using trigonometry. Drawing them tail to tail will help out a lot. For the I component, we have 700 sine 60 degrees, and for the J component, we have 700 cos 60 degrees. Let's simplify this. Now that we have both velocities, we have to use our relative velocity equation. The question says we need to find the velocity of plane B with respect to plane A. So our relative velocity equation will look like this. Now we can plug in VB and VA. Let's solve for relative velocity. All we're doing is adding up the same components. So I components to I components, and J components to J components. Now we will find the magnitude of this vector. Let's draw the vector components tail to tail to understand what we're looking for. Notice how this creates a right angle triangle. We're trying to find the hypotenuse of this triangle, which is the magnitude. Finding just the magnitude isn't enough. We also need to find the angle that's created to show the direction. We can find that by using tan inverse. So the answer to this question, which is to find the velocity of plane B with respect to plane A, is the magnitude along with the angle. Let's look at another example. In this question, we need to find the velocity and acceleration of car A with respect to car B. The first step is to establish which sides are positive. So as before, we will pick up and to the right to be positive. Let's focus on car B first, since it's going in a straight line. We will write its velocity and acceleration in Cartesian vector form. For velocity, it's going to have one component, which is 100 J, because the car is traveling at 100 kilometers per hour. Now for the acceleration. The question says it's decelerating at 250 kilometers per hour squared. So the acceleration component is actually facing down, which means it's negative 250 J. Let's leave those aside and look at car A. The velocity is pretty straightforward, since at the instant we're looking at the car, it only has one component, which is 20 kilometers per hour straight down, so negative 20 J. For acceleration, we need to keep in mind that it's traveling along a curve. You'll remember from previous chapters that objects traveling along a curve will have a normal acceleration along with a tangential acceleration. So we need to find both of those. The tangential acceleration is given to us in the question, which is 300 kilometers per hour squared. Now we need to find the normal acceleration. For that, we can use this equation. We know the velocity, which is 20 kilometers per hour, and we know the radius of the curve. Since we're using kilometers per hour for the velocity, we need to make sure we convert 100 meters to kilometers before plugging it into our equation. Solving gives us the normal acceleration. It's important to note that these are not in Cartesian vector form, so we need to write them as vectors. First, the tangential acceleration. Since it's accelerating, the vector is going straight down, so it's negative 300 j. Now remember that normal acceleration always points towards the center of the curve. In this case, due to the position of the car, the vector arrow is pointing along the horizontal axis towards the center. So the normal acceleration is negative 4000 i. Negative because it's pointing to the left and we chose right to be positive. So the total acceleration of car A is the addition of both normal and tangential acceleration. So we now have the velocity and acceleration written as vector components. We can start applying the relative equations. We will start with the velocity. The question says to determine the relative velocity of car A with respect to car B. So our equation will look like this. Let's plug in what we found and solve. Since there is only the J component, the magnitude is simply 120 kilometers per hour straight down. For acceleration, we will do the same. So let's write our relative acceleration equation. Plug in what we know and solve. Let's draw the vector components and solve for the magnitude. To find the angle, we will use tan inverse. Those are our answers. Let's look at another example. In this question, we need to find the speed and the angle that the man must direct his boat so that it goes from points A to B. This one is a bit different because we're given the magnitude of velocity, so we're sort of working backwards. As usual, we will pick up and to the right to be positive. From the question, we know the river is flowing at 2 meters per second. So we can write the velocity of the river flow in Cartesian form as 2i. Next, we need to calculate the angle from points A to B. That's the angle the boat will travel along. So for that, we can use tan inverse, since it's a right angle triangle. Now let's break the velocity of the boat into components. We don't know the velocity, but we do have the angle. So we can write the sine and cosine components like this. Let's simplify it a bit. This represents just the velocity of the boat in Cartesian vector form. So we have the velocity of the river, the velocity of the boat, and now we need the relative velocity of the boat with respect to the river. That's given to us as well, which is 5 meters per second, but we don't know the angle. This angle is different from the angle the boat is traveling at. Let's write it in Cartesian form. Now we can write our relative velocity equation. Let's plug in what we know. Now we will equate each of the components. So I components to I components and J components to J components. We get two equations with two unknowns. All we need to do is solve for them. You can solve them any way you like and you will get the velocity and the angle. Those are our answers. Let's look at one last example. This one is similar to the second question we did, the only difference being that the car is actually on a curve at an angle. So let's see how we can break it into components. Let's start off by first choosing up and to the right to be positive. We will first focus on car A and write down the velocity in Cartesian vector form. Since it's going straight up, it's going to be 40j. For acceleration, the question says it's traveling at a constant velocity, so the acceleration is 0. Let's look at car B now. The velocity can be broken into two components. So we get negative 30 sine 30 degrees and 30 cos 30 degrees. Let's simplify it. Now let's think about the acceleration. The car is on a curve, so there will be normal and tangential acceleration. The tangential acceleration is given to us in the question, which is 2 meters per second squared. Now let's find the normal acceleration. For that, we can use this equation. The velocity is 30 meters per second, and the radius of curvature is given to us, which is 200 meters. Let's solve. Now we have both accelerations, but remember, they are not in Cartesian vector form. Let's write them as vectors, starting with the tangential acceleration. So the tangential acceleration will have two components. I've drawn the components, let's place them tail to tail. So we have negative 2 sine 30 degrees and 2 cos 30 degrees. Let's simplify these. Now for the normal acceleration. Remember that it always points towards the center of the curve. So we will also break this acceleration into components like this. I've drawn the components along with the new axes, so you can see that each component, if we put it tail to tail, it creates a triangle with a 30 degree angle. So we get negative 4.5 cos 30 degrees and negative 4.5 sine 30 degrees. Let's simplify these. Now that we broke both accelerations into vector components, the total acceleration of car B is the addition of all of these components. So we're going to add the components together. Everything we need is calculated, so we can start applying our relative velocity and acceleration equations. Let's start off with velocity. The question says we need to find the velocity of car B with respect to car A. So our equation looks like this. Let's plug in what we found and solve. Now we will calculate the magnitude. The angle can be found using tan inverse. Now for acceleration. Let's use the relative acceleration equation and plug in what we know and solve. Now we can find the magnitude. The angle can be found using tan inverse. Those are our answers. That pretty much covers the problems you will face in this chapter. If this video helped you, please give a thumbs up. Thanks for watching and best of luck with your studies.